Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Vishnu, and these are the major news stories of Tuesday, April 23rd, 2024. A Delhi court extended the judicial custody of Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and BRS leader Kavita in the excise policy case till May 7th. Expanding the scope of its hearing in the Patanjali Ayurved case, the Supreme Court took a stern view of misleading advertisements by fast-moving consumer goods firms and asked the centre to inform it about the steps they have taken to curb the practice which takes the public for a ride and adversely affects their health. Amid the row over his redistribution of wealth remarks, Prime Minister Narendra Modi again charged that the Congress was hatching a deep conspiracy to snatch people's wealth and distribute it among select people. Israel bombarded northern Gaza overnight in some of the heaviest shelling in weeks, causing panic amongst residents and flattening neighborhoods in an area from which the Israeli army had previously withdrawn its troops. Kerala Police on Tuesday filed the charge sheet in the Kalamashiri blast case, naming Dominic Martin as the lone accused. Let's get into the details. A Delhi court on Tuesday extended the judicial custody of Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and BRS leader K. Kavita in a money laundering case related to the alleged excise policy scam till May 7th. Earlier, Kejriwal was administered a low dose of insulin after his blood sugar level spiked, said officials of Tihar Jail. The Delhi Chief Minister was arrested on March 21st by the Enforcement Directorate in connection with a money laundering case linked to the Delhi government's now-scrapped excise policy. He is lodged in Tihar Jail since April 1st. Meanwhile, the Delhi High Court has listed for hearing on May 15th Kejriwal's petition challenging the summonses issued to him by the ED. Expanding the scope of its hearing in the Patanjali Ayurved case, the Supreme Court on Tuesday took a stern view of misleading advertisements by fast-moving consumer goods firms and asked three union ministries to inform it about the steps they have taken to curb the practice which takes public for a ride and adversely affects their health. The court passed the order after Yoga Guru Ramdev and his aide Balkrishna of Patanjali Ayurved Limited told a bench of Justices Hima Kohli and Hasanuddin Amanullah that they have issued unqualified public apology in as many as 67 newspapers over misleading advertisements and are willing to issue additional advertisements expressing their contrition. The bench said the public apology published in newspapers were not on record and asked those to be filed within 2 days. It posted the matter for April 30th for further consideration. While hearing the Patanjali case, the apex court said the implementation of the relevant provisions of the Drugs and Magic Remedies Objectionable Advertisements Act, the Drugs and Cosmetics Act and the Consumer Protection Act and the related rules also needed a closer examination. It said the issue was not limited to Patanjali but extended to all fast-moving consumer goods firms which have been issuing misleading advertisements and taking the public for a ride, in particular affecting the health of babies, school-going children and senior citizens who have been consuming products on the basis of the said misrepresentation. The court asked the Union Ministries of Consumer Affairs, Information and Broadcasting and Information Technology to explain what action they have taken to prevent the misuse of consumer laws. On April 16th, the apex court had warned Ramdev and Balkrishna against any attempt to degrade allopathy and permitted them to tender a public apology and show contrition within a week in the contempt proceedings in the misleading advertisements case against Patanjali Ayurved Limited. The apex court is hearing a plea filed in 2022 by the IMA, alleging a smear campaign against the COVID vaccination drive and modern systems of medicine. Ramdev and Balkrishna had earlier tendered an unconditional and unqualified apology before the top court over advertisements issued by the firm making tall claims about the medicinal efficacy of its products. Amid the row over his redistribution of wealth remarks, Prime Minister Narendra Modi again charged that the Congress was hatching a deep conspiracy to snatch people's wealth and distribute it among select people. He also claimed that Congress tried to extend reservation based on religion and give it to Muslims. Modi said it was difficult to follow one's faith under the Congress and that even listening to Hanuman Chalisa becomes a crime under that party's rule. His specific reference to the Lord came on a day when large parts of the country are celebrating the Hanuman Jayanti. Modi had said the then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh had given a speech in which he had said that Muslims have the first right to the resources of the country. Congress already clarified that Modi had misinterpreted the former Prime Minister's words. In a speech given at the 52nd meeting of the National Development Council, Manmohan Singh spoke about collective priorities. He said sectors like agriculture, irrigation, water resources, health and education should be developed along with programs for the upliftment of scheduled castes and tribes, other backward classes, minorities and women and children. He said innovative plans would have to be devised to ensure that minorities, particularly the Muslim community, are empowered to share equitably in the fruits of development. However, Modi claimed he has exposed the Congress's vote bank politics. At a rally in Rajasthan on Sunday, Modi had said that if the Congress came to power, it would redistribute the wealth of people to infiltrators and those who have more children, and cited former PM Manmohan Singh's remark that the minority community had the first claim on the country's resources. Israel bombarded northern Gaza overnight in some of the heaviest shelling in weeks, causing panic amongst residents and flattening neighborhoods in an area from which the Israeli army had previously withdrawn its troops, residents said on Tuesday. Army tanks made a new incursion on the northern edge of the Gaza Strip, though they did not penetrate far into the city, residents and Hamas media said. Gunfire reached some schools where displaced residents were sheltering. This month, Israel also drew down most of its forces in southern Gaza, but efforts to reach a ceasefire have failed, and Israeli bombardment and raids on territory where its troops have withdrawn are making it difficult for displaced Gazans to return to abandoned homes. Israel also struck Khan Yunis in the south on Tuesday, a day after tanks raided eastern parts of that city. Israel says it is seeking to eradicate Hamas, which controls the enclave, following an attack by the militant group on October 7th, killing 1,200 and taking 253 hostages by Israeli tallies. Across the Gaza Strip, Israel's military strikes killed 32 Palestinians and wounded 59 others in the past 24 hours, Palestinian health authorities said. They say more than 34,000 people have been confirmed killed in the 7-month war, with thousands more bodies as yet unrecovered. The police team probing the Kalamashiri blast in which 8 people were killed has submitted the charge sheet to the trial court. The charge sheet has named Dominic Martin, a native of Thamilam in Ernakulam, as the lone accused. The charge sheet states that Martin committed the crime to mark his protest against the Jehovah's Witnesses sect with which he was associated once. The charge sheet, which has 3,578 pages, was submitted to the Ernakulam Principal Sessions Court by the Kochi City Deputy Police Commissioner, who is the investigation officer in the case. Martin has been slapped with sections under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act and the Explosive Substances Act. He has been charged with murder and attempt to murder. There are 294 witnesses in the case, as many as 137 material evidence and 236 documents have been submitted to the court. The police have found that Martin wanted to bring Jehovah's Witnesses to the attention of the government and the public and get it banned. The blast, which sent shockwaves across the country, took place on October 29, 2023, at a convention center during a prayer meeting of the Christian sect. 2 people were killed on the spot and the other succumbed to burn injuries while undergoing treatment. Over 50 individuals were injured in the blast. A few hours after the incident, Martin surrendered before the police in Thrissur and confessed to the crime. Martin committed the crime using an improvised explosive device he had made. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted and produced by me, Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from IW Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.